Nikki Haley's run for governor ran through WYFF News 4 today. She and I sat down for a one-on-one interview this afternoon. We talked about the sex scandal that broke during the primary campaign, but we covered much more than that. Her moment of victory arrived on the heels of a primary stained by accusations of infidelity. Blogger Will Folks and consultant Larry Marchand made claims Haley denied by simply saying she'd been completely faithful to her husband, Michael. I gave her a chance to go a step further. Have you ever had sex or any sort of romantic relationship outside your marriage?
No, I have not. And I think that's unfortunate that we're still having that conversation, because I think that, if anything, what the primary and the runoff showed was that people care about the message, and they care about what we're trying to do in government, and they care about the economy and jobs and people's wallets. And that, at the end of the day, needs to be the conversation. It should never be about the negative distractions of opponents.
I want to give you a chance here to define faithful to the people of South Carolina. What do you mean when you say we've been faithful to one another?
He is my partner, not only at home with my family, but he is also my partner in work, and he is everything that I would hope to have in a husband. He's going to be everything as a first man, but in marriage, we are best friends. There's nothing he doesn't know that I don't tell him. There's nothing I don't know that he doesn't tell me. We love each other dearly, and we love our family.
If Republicans are a family, Senator Jake Knotts helped divide them when he called Nikki Haley a raghead. Yet she's determined to let her victory as an Indian American woman stand as her response.
See, South Carolina is not about the ignorance of a senator. It is about good people that make good decisions and that want good government. And that's what I hope people will take away from it. That was an ignorant comment from one senator that I have put no more weight on, and I don't think the people of this state need to give one more thought to.
Her endorsement by Sarah Palin clearly helped Haley tap into voter discontent in South Carolina. Yet in our interview, she seemed determined not to be defined by any marquee name.
Well, just like Governor Sanford and I are different, Governor Palin and I are different. But I think what she has brought to our country in terms of people knowing the power of their voice is a great thing.
Her voice, aimed at the voter, carries the unique chords of a populist revolution.
I think the Haley administration is going to be completely different. I think it will have the cutting wasteful spending and accountability of the Sanford administration, but I think it is going to bring a whole new dynamic to true reform in every single agency, like what we've seen in the DMV, where people are greeted at the door and in and out of there in 10 or 15 minutes. I want that in every single agency.
She campaigned hard with the promise of radical change, yet she vows to get along with the State House leadership. Her promises remain clear, and they are very bold.
We're going to make sure that we eliminate the corporate income tax and do something with the personal income tax. We're going to have total tax reform in a way that rewards people for being successful. We are going to strengthen workers' comp reform. We're going to strengthen tort reform. But at the end of the day, this movement is about returning government back to the people. We're going to be that state where everybody says, that's how you do it. We're going to be that state where everybody says, don't look at what she did in 3 or 4 years. Look at what she did in the very first year, and we helped her do it.
It is my great pleasure. It is with humility and respect that I accept the Republican Party's nomination to be your next governor of South Carolina.
Nikki Haley appears ever confident the movement that has brought her this far will carry her on.
We've got great opportunities in front of us. I'm very excited about where we're going.
Nikki Haley's Democratic opponent is Vincent Shaheen, and during our interview today, she complimented him, saying he will serve his party well, but she pointed out they differ on the issues. Also, the state Republican Party so far has not officially chastised Senator Jake Knotts for that ethnic slur. Today, Haley told me she's okay with that, saying how the party handles him is up to the party.